Daniel Kinnebro, this is our weekly Bible study recap. Listen, our focus for the next couple of weeks is going to be on the journey through life, the journey through trouble, the journey through to recovery, just the journey alone. And we talked about life has many journeys that all of us will have to travel. Some of us lose jobs and deal with financial hardship. Some of us lose a loved one. Some of us deal with addictions. Some of us have all these different proclivities that we have to conquer. But the thing is, what we talked about last night was this one component right here. We ask the wrong question. The question we usually ask is, how long will it be? Wrong question. How long the journey will be has nothing to do, because there's a greater question. The question is, who's with you? Because any of y'all ever taken a long road trip, if you've ever taken a long road trip, you know a long road trip can be shorter based on the people who are in the car with you. If you're having fun laughing and joking, singing crazy songs, whatever you're doing, that time, even though it could be 8 hours, it could be 10 hours, if you're with the right people, right, it makes the journey seem shorter. And what we're challenging all of us to do, and you all as well, is to find the right people in your life. I was listening to a sermon by Pastor Albert Tate, and he said this. He said every Christian should have at least 2 to 3 people you know who are praying for you by name every day. He said you should have at least 2 to 3 people that you're praying for by name, that you're praying for and that are praying for you by name every day. Do you know those 2, 3 people? Those are the people who are on your journey with you. Listen to this one scripture in 2 Timothy chapter 4, when Paul is about to be executed for his faith. Listen to what he says in verse 9. One verse, and it's only 6 words. Please come as soon as you can. Actually 7. But please come as soon as you can. What was he saying? He was saying that, and if you continue to read the rest of the scripture, he's talking about that people have deserted him. He's all by himself. Yes, he know he's doing God's will. Yes, he know he's standing up for the right cause. But as he's getting closer to the end, he's lonely. And what will make the journey easier if he has people walking with him? This is why I believe God put in Psalms 23 in David's heart, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I know that thou art with me. And we talk about how God can come in different form. It could be that coworker you didn't expect to be a friend at this time. It could be that family member that keeps calling you and texting you and checking on you. When people are around you, it makes the journey easier. So what is my challenge to you? My challenge to you is very simple. Who's on your journey with you? Stop worrying about how long the journey is and find the right people to ride with you. Who you riding with? You know what I'm saying? That's the question. And if you truly ride with people through life, it makes the journey shorter. It makes the love greater. And God is glorified. So go pray for 2 or 3 of your friends specifically, and go find people to pray for you. And let me add this. When you get people to pray for you, tell them specifically what they're praying for. Don't just give, pray that I just get better or life gets better. No, tell them, I'm having a problem with my kid. I need help here. My finances are jacked up. I need help here. So please be honest. Find 2 or 3 people to pray for, and you be honest with people so they can pray for you too. All right. Have a great week. Talk to you later. Bye.